Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, we are going to be making this distressed peekaboo tumbler. This is not at all what I had planned in my head for this, but when things don't go as planned, sometimes you just have to go with the flow and you end up with a pretty amazing result. So I'm going to walk you through my process of getting this design. We are using a 12 ounce slim koozie from the Steel Magnolia. This is one of my favorites because it's amazing for a adult beverage, or it can also be a kid's cup or a coffee cup because you can put a regular lid on this for a 16 ounce regular tumbler, or you can switch it out with a HydroFit lid and it's perfect for water or a little kid's cup with the handle. The paint color I used is one of my new favorites. It is Boudreaux from Krylon, and oh my gosh, it is such a beautiful color. I used my glitter glue from the Crystal Light Company to apply Empire State from PDB Glitters. I allowed this to sit for about 3 to 4 hours. I applied a layer of Rust-Oleum matte clear coat over this just because I wanted to minimize the amount of microbubbles in my first epoxy layer and minimize the amount of epoxy that I had to use to get to this next step. I used one layer of a little extra ink epoxy and then sanded the tumbler really well. You will hear from a lot of people that you can see sand lines through spray paint when doing a peekaboo if you sand prior to doing that. However, if you use a fine grit to finish that off prior to spray painting, you're going to even those spray paint lines out and you're not going to be able to see them. As you can see, the vinyl that I was using gave me so much trouble. I was trying to use up some vinyl that I got on clearance from the craft store, and it was horrible. Anytime I used it, it lifted from my cups, and I don't like to waste, so I said, well, I'll just use it for my peekaboos since it is a temporary vinyl. Yeah, it wasn't a good idea. And this was actually my second attempt on trying to put it on my tumbler. And yes, I'm totally showing my struggle here because I know that it is super frustrating when things do not go the way that they're supposed to, especially when you have, you know, time-sensitive orders. But we all have the same issues. I promise you, I have issues every single day that I touch these cups or even step into my craft room. Something is bound to happen. In the midst of my struggle, I remembered that I had someone comment, why don't you just remove the backing completely and roll your cup on the table onto the decal? So I thought, okay, well, maybe that would work. And why have I not done this before? Because that went so smooth. Once I pressed that down really well, I took my tumbler and spray painted it this matte sea green. And really, this isn't a color I would ever think of combining with a plum purple and burgundy and gold on a tumbler. But this is the decal that I was originally gonna use, and it matched this tumbler so well, I decided to use it on that, and I had to find a different one for this one. And once I changed from that larger decal, this green was a little bit too bold for me, so I said, okay, well, we will distress it. I originally was gonna use acrylic paints because you can do that as well with these brush strokes, but I wanted to use alcohol ink so it could withstand the wet sanding that I was going to do to sort of break this green up just a little. When doing my brush strokes, I just tried to keep them all in the same direction so that it doesn't look like they're, you know, curving or anything like that. And I always go heavier around the edges anytime I'm doing a wood grain or distressing like this, because when you have a vintage piece or antique, normally that is where it has the most wear, is around the edges of it. So I wanted the same effect on this. Once I finished with my alcohol inks, I moved straight into sanding down some of those areas with various grits of sandpaper. Now, when you use sandpaper to distress rather than alcohol or acetone, you are gonna see those strokes. So it's very important to make sure that you go in the same direction everywhere. So although you are distressing it, it does seem put together. If you want more of a clean look and you do not want to see those sand marks, definitely make sure that you have a glossy finish prior to doing your decal and spray paint, and then you can go in with acetone and then follow that up with alcohol. That way you can get a really nice clean distressed look, if that's a thing. Now I skipped this forward, but I did spend quite a bit of time on this because I used those higher grit sandpaper or finer. But really anything will work, any grit of sandpaper. The lower you go, the more you are gonna see those sand lines, and that's really the only difference. After that, I dried it off really well, removed my vinyl, and moved straight into my A Little Extra Ink Epoxy application. Since this is a peekaboo and requires more layers of epoxy, I did just do a thin layer for this step, and I did not record it, but I added a little bit of Tipsy from PDB Creative Studios to put in a little bit of pink that is going to be in our decal. Now, I have used some of these before in one of my tutorials. This is the Cacti Rub-On Transfers from Southern Belle Glitter. I am so obsessed with these, y'all. I cannot even explain it. These have a milky white background on the image itself. You can see that here. So you can put it on a dark surface and it is going to be nice and bright. Now these do have adhesive on the back and they pull away from that clear sheet. So make sure that you do have that positioned correctly the first time. Spend a little extra time there. I rub it down with my finger and then take the tool over it that come with the transfers. Very slowly, this is sped up, but very slowly remove that clear piece and you will be left with an amazing decal. I gave this two final coats of epoxy to seal in my decal really well, and look at the result, y'all. I never would have thought that these color combinations would look so well with each other, but they did, and I absolutely love it. I hope that y'all enjoyed this tutorial. As always, all the materials I used will be down in the description below with some discount codes for y'all. Don't forget, we are on Instagram and we do have a Facebook group where I share additional tips and tricks and have lots of fun and giveaways. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and hit the little bell to be notified next time a new tutorial drops. That is all for today. Thank y'all.